Hi, my name is Fabrício Laguna, also known as the Brazilian BA. My challenge here is to present you Scrum, or the Scrum Guide. It's the most popular framework for agile software development. Scrum is so popular that a lot of people just think that agile and Scrum are synonymous. They mean the same thing. When you ask someone, "I'm working with Agile," he thinks like, "Yes, we have a product owner, Scrum Master, so we do." Scrum and Agile are different subjects. This is not the subject of this video today, but what I would like to present to you is what Scrum really is, based on the Scrum Guides. We may say that Scrum is a framework to structure how a group of people can work together to develop or maintain a product, a framework, not a methodology. Some people may even say it is a methodology, but it's not a complete methodology. There are some places where you can put your own techniques, your own definitions, so it's a basis for you to develop your way to work with your team and develop your products. Scrum has a guide called the Scrum Guide, and it is already very simple. But my challenge here is to make it even simpler than that, presenting you Scrum on a single page using a concept model. I created this model for my studies of Scrum, and you may use it for your studies as well. There's a printable version of this poster, and you can download it in a link available here in the description of this video. Let me present you this model, starting with the key concepts. The first one is the Scrum pillars. There are three pillars in Scrum. Transparency. Everybody must be able to see what's going on, and this enables inspection of the work, so we can see what's going on and if it's going right or wrong. And inspection enables adaptation. Second concept of Scrum is the Scrum values. There are five values in Scrum: commitment of the team, the focus on the objectives of the product, openness for everyone sees what's going on, respect with the team members, and courage to take the decisions that are needed. The other concepts in Scrum are classes of concepts. The first one is the Scrum team, formed by three roles that we are going to see in a minute. It's a team that's formed for at most 10 people, should be a multifunctional team. It means that every skills necessary to develop the product must be part of the team, and self-managing team. Nobody outside of the team is going to give orders about how this team should work, who should do what. The other class of concepts are artifacts. There are three different artifacts in Scrum. I will present them in a minute, but they represent work or value that this team is creating during the work. The other class of concepts is a commitment. A commitment is something the team must commit to see if they are going to the right direction. You may use the commitments to measure if you're delivering what is expected to deliver. And the last class of concepts is the Scrum events. They are all time limited, and they provide an opportunity for which you inspect the artifacts of Scrum and see if they are going in the direction of the commitments. Let's open now for the more specific concepts of Scrum. Let's start with the Scrum team. There are three roles in the Scrum. The product owner, one product owner per Scrum team, one Scrum Master per Scrum team, and until 10 developers. The product owner, starting with him. He's the accountable for maximizing the value of the product. He is the one responsible for managing what we call the product backlog. This is the first artifact of Scrum. The product backlog maintains all the work and value that must be delivered by the product team. For each artifact, there is a commitment related to it. And for the product backlog, the commitment is the product goal. The product goal directs the product backlog, saying to the team where this product should end. What's the final state for that product? We may say that the product backlog is formed by product backlog items. Every product backlog item is a small part of work that must be delivered by the product team. We may say also that the commitment product goal is a product backlog item because they are all part of the product backlog. Well, let's talk now about another role of Scrum. Let's talk about the Scrum Master. The Scrum Master is that one that fosters the Scrum values into the Scrum team. He is responsible for the people to keep going oriented for the Scrum pillars. He works for the team as a leader that serves the team and helps them to find the benefits of using the framework Scrum to work on a product. The Scrum Master should ensure that the events of Scrum are happening. The first event we are going to see is the Sprint. Sprint may be seen as a container where all other events happen inside Scrum. The duration of a Sprint may change from company to company, but usually we may say that it should not pass over 1 month. Every sprint should start with a sprint planning. At the sprint planning, we should plan and define all the work that's going to be delivered by the sprint. The sprint planning defines what we call the sprint backlog, a plan that's made by those developers that we said before and that's going to be executed by them. A sprint backlog is formed by the product backlog items selected from the product backlog. The Scrum team must look for what is viable to be delivered during a sprint. Besides the product backlog selected items, the sprint backlog is also formed by a commitment. Remember that for each artifact, there is a commitment. And for the sprint backlog, the commitment is the sprint goal. The goal should describe the outcomes of the sprint without describing the outputs of it. In other words, it should not describe what the team must do, but what the team must deliver. And we may also find in a sprint backlog a work plan. The plan is the set of actions planned by the developers to be done during the sprint. As I have been saying a lot about developers, let me present them. A developer is any person involved in the development of the product increment into the Scrum. Don't confuse developers with code developers. Developer may have very different functions working in this group. You may have system engineers, testers, you may have designers, painters, gardeners, whatever you need for the kind of product that you are developing. They are all known in this framework as developers. And those developers are those responsible to create what we call the increment, the last artifact of Scrum. An increment is part of the product, a part that you are going to add to the working product in every sprint. Did I mention that a sprint starts whenever the last sprint ended? So, for every sprint, you are going to increment your product with some new capacities, with new usable functions of that product. The commitment of the increment is the definition of done. The definition of done is a statement that says that an increment is good to go to production or to be added to the product if some quality measures are met. Now, let's take a look at the other events that happens inside the sprint. After the sprint planning, we have the daily Scrum. Meetings with no more than 15 minutes that should happen every day. It's attended by the developers and they should see what's going on, what's going wrong or right, and adjust the work plan to attend the sprint backlog and guarantee that the sprint will deliver the sprint goal. At the end of our sprint, there are two different events that's going to happen. First of them is the sprint review, where the Scrum team calls some key stakeholders and present the increment of the product. They can do an inspection in the sprint outcomes or the sprint results and make some adjustments if necessary to the product backlog. And the last event on Scrum is the sprint retrospective. This is the event that concludes a sprint. It's an event not for stakeholders outside of the Scrum team, it's just for the Scrum team, and the inspection is not going to be made in the increment or the results of the Scrum, but in the way that the work is being done. The sprint retrospective may adjust how the team is working in the Scrum. Well, I believe I presented you all the concept model of the Scrum Guide. I recommend that you read the Scrum Guide. It's easy to understand, very thin book, but the model may help you to find the key concepts and study it easier. Or it may be useful for you to use with your team to present Scrum and to discuss who is doing what, where are your artifacts, if you are really using correctly all the concepts on this picture. I remember you that Scrum is a framework. That means that it should be complemented with other stuff. There are other roles that may be useful for your company or for your team that are not described in Scrum. Scrum does not define artifacts inside the product backlog, like if you should use requirements using this technique or that other technique. Scrum does not offer you also a tool, a software tool, where you can manage your product backlog or manage your meetings, your events, your sprint planning, your work plan. All those complements may be defined by your team for your organization to meet your needs. There are a lot of other frameworks, techniques, and useful informations to make your company more agile. But if you are supposed to create and manage a product and you are going to create a team to support it, Scrum may be very useful to you. If you like this model, check the link below and download it for you to print and to use it with your team. If you like this video, take a look in other videos here in the Brazilian BA channel. Thank you and see you soon.